The second step of cellular respiration is something called the Krebs cycle or the citric acid cycle. This is a cycle of reactions that's going to do a couple things. It's going to remove electrons and hydrogen ions from pyruvate, and then it's going to use them to build more NADH and FADH2. We talked about FADH as a taxicab that's going to pick up hydrogens and electrons. FADH is another taxicab. So we have yellow cabs and red cabs. Chemically different, the differences aren't so important, but both of them are going to be shuttles. So this cycle is going to take electrons and hydrogens off and load up these cabs. All of this is going to be based off of pyruvate. And remember, the source of pyruvate is glycolysis. So you're going to use glycolysis to create pyruvates. The pyruvates are then going to be stripped down of all of their electrons and hydrogens. So pyruvate is going to move from the cytoplasm into the mitochondria. Krebs cycle needs to happen in this particular organelle. It's going to be converted into something called acetyl-CoA, and this is a two-carbon molecule that can then enter this Krebs cycle. Notice in the conversion, we create a little bit of NADH, we load up one taxicab, and we also create a leftover carbon dioxide molecule. As we go through this cycle, we're going to generate additional carbon dioxides, load up some more NADH taxicabs, and an FADH2. In addition, per pyruvate that's going through this cycle, we're going to generate one ATP. One pyruvate generates one ATP. Glucose generates two pyruvates through glycolysis, so we're going to make two ATP molecules per glucose in the Krebs cycle. If you think back, so far we got two net ATPs from glycolysis, the first step. Now we're getting two ATPs from our Krebs cycle. And then we've also got some loaded taxicabs. And so far that's all we've gotten from cellular respiration. As I mentioned, carbon dioxide is produced as a waste product here. I think everyone knows that when you breathe out carbon dioxide. But here's the reason. The whole reason that your body is generating carbon dioxide, as it breaks down sugars to make ATP, during the Krebs cycle, it's generating these extra carbon dioxides that your body doesn't need. That's going to filter back into your bloodstream, back to your lungs, and you're going to breathe it back out. So here's a video summary of what happens in the Krebs cycle.